Hello everyone, welcome to this episode on landscape photography. I am Abhishek and I have Naveen, my colleague from Nikon India technical team.
Hi Abhishek.
Hello Naveen. Just to define landscape photography for our viewers, what do you have to say?
I think the ideal definition for landscape photography would be wherein in your picture, the landscape is the main subject. Now there might as well be other elements like human elements or architectural structures, but all of that should convey your picture to a major landscape or how important the landscape is in the picture.
But I believe the best way to demonstrate landscape photography is not inside these four walls of studio.
Definitely not.
So what do you think? We shall move out in the field and help our viewers understand how to pull out beautiful landscape images.
Sounds like a brilliant idea, but I would love to know where we are headed to.
We are heading towards Kerala.
God's own country.
God's own country. So let's move out.
Let's
and
do that. Absolutely.
Do some real shooting. Naveen, finally we have chosen this location for our practical demonstration of aesthetics of landscape photography.
So, just to tell you about the place, this is in Kerala. We are at a small hill town called Kumuli, as you can see. Now, the reason why we majorly chose this location was for the layers that we get. As you can see, it's mountains behind one another.
Most of the people who want to get into landscape photography, they normally avoid taking tripods.
Correct.
Because it's painful to carry
exactly.
Tripod everywhere. But having a sturdy tripod for landscape shot is very, very important.
It's a must, in fact.
Yeah. Also, one more thing I want to clarify to our viewers that in windy situation, in order to stabilize your camera, you just need to wrap this strap and fix it somewhere so that it doesn't move. What about lenses?
Usually one has this perception that, you know, ultra wide, include everything, and that's landscape photography.
The key ingredients of landscape photography is foreground, mid-ground and background.
Yeah.
So again, as you can see, we have grass in the foreground along with that tree in the corner.
Correct.
Then in the mid-ground we have these layers of mountains, and in the background we have dramatic sky. Now the major challenge that most of the people who are into landscape photography or want to learn landscape photography is where to focus.
Usually when we shoot landscape, we look for a larger depth of field wherein we want everything in focus. Like you can see here, we have a foreground, mid-ground and background. So we want all these three layers to be in sharp focus.
Right.
Now always remember that your depth of field is largely dependent on what aperture you're using, your focal length and your focus point. Understand that your area of focus or your depth of field is centered around the focus point. So let's say when we talk about hyperfocal distance, let's assume I'm pointing or I'm placing my focus point on the tree over here. So at hyperfocal distance, ideally I'm getting sharpness 2/3 ahead of the tree and 1/3 towards the camera.
Right.
So that much of area will be in sharp focus. So as in any other genres of photography, landscape also has to be composed well. So the most common rule of composition being the rule of thirds, where you divide your frame into three equal parts horizontally and vertically, that'll give you an intersection point.
So it's like divide your whole frame into 9 columns.
Exactly.
And place some of the interesting element in one of the intersection points.
Exactly. Where the points, where the lines are actually joining, those are your point of interest, as we call it.
So here we are setting our camera at f16, ISO, let me keep as per the lighting condition, 125. And then I set my shutter speed right. White balance, we are using daylight because sun is peeping out every now and then. Let's take a shot. Let's try it.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
That looks nice.
So you have dramatic sky and beautiful tree in the corner and balanced by this mountain.
Also, if you notice in this picture, the horizon is not exactly in the center. As in, the horizon should never divide your frame exactly through the middle.
Why don't we take our viewers to some other location and try out different other rules of composition when it comes to landscape photography?
Let's take a walk around.
Yeah. So Naveen, we are here now at a different location to talk about another rule of composition, which is called layering. And when we talk about layering, zooming into your landscape shot means you're adding layers. So in this shot, if you see, the first layer is this mountain.
Yeah.
The second layer is the house, which is the key element in this shot. And then the background with the sky and a little bit of clouds.
Right.
And see where we have kept the house in this particular image, right?
The point of interest, remember? Yeah.
Yeah. So I think zoom lenses can also be used as much as wide angle lenses for landscape.
In fact, zoom lens compresses your layers.
Yeah, zoom lens tends to compress your background and gives you more depth. When it comes to landscape photography. So if you've been into using a lot of wide angle lenses for landscape photography, try using zooms.
Okay, Abhishek, so here we are at a different location. Now, as you can see, the light is of course different from here.
Right.
It's diffused, I guess.
And clarity is very good.
Exactly.
So it's a, you can say, a apt location for landscape photography.
Right.
And we have chosen this location in the middle of a tea estate.
Yeah.
Reason being, today we are talking about another important rule of composition when it comes to landscape photography, which is called lead-in lines.
Correct.
So, and for lead-in lines, we have to have a pattern or a shape which leads you towards the subject or away from the subject.
Exactly. Alright, so as you can see, right now what we are using here is a Nikon D3300 and the lens is a 10-24, which is an ultra-wide. This can get you beautiful landscape images. So, let's try shooting with this. So, yeah, that's one more tip for our viewers. Don't make your line travel exactly through the center. Make it start from one corner so that it travels through the, you know, to the other corner of the image. Wow, that's nice.
So as you can see, you know, this path is leading you into the image, and there are so many converging lines. Coming
exactly.
From the top, left top of the hill, and then right hand side, you can see. And they are all colliding with each other and intersecting at the background.
Exactly.
Let's see if we add life into it to create more drama in our landscape shot. So exactly. That we'll try now. So, here we have Kanchan with us from Delhi. She's a professional model. And with the help of Kanchan, we will try and establish how life can be added in your landscape shots.
Yes.
It is very important that now we switch our focusing mode from AFS to AFC. Because now she is walking, so it is very important to track focus on her. That will lock on focus onto her and we can get sharp shots. Also, please note, earlier our ISO was little on a lower side to keep the quality intact, but now we'll have to boost our ISO depending on the lighting condition. And since we have increased the shutter speed, so to keep the exposure balanced, it is very important to increase the ISO as well.
Exactly.
Okay, Kanchan, action! So it's not necessary that every time you need to get a female model to exactly. Add value to your landscape shots.
In fact, I believe adding your own family members, two reasons, they are cheaper and they appear a lot more natural in your frame because they know who's shooting you.
The only thing that I want to advise that if you want to include your friends, relatives, family members as a human element and adding life to your landscape shot, ask them not to pose for you.
Exactly.
Like standing like this and just looking into the camera, those shots are very boring.
Yeah.
Ask them to do something, some activity, moving around, having fun, enjoying the scenery, the valley, landscape.
Exploring the place.
Exactly. That adds more natural touch to your landscape shots.
Absolutely.
And give you more beautiful, lively shots. Thank you. here we are at the sand dunes of Jaisalmer, Thar Desert. Just to add different flavor to landscape photography, what we are trying to achieve today is shooting at a beautiful light. It's right now 7 o'clock in the morning, and we deliberately wanted to shoot the sand dunes in this light because that golden light reflection comes really beautifully from the sand. And the idea here is to shoot the sunrise, keeping sun in one corner as per the rule of thirds. Along with that, we will try and accommodate some balancing element. Right now, what I see in front of me, in the foreground sand dunes, then in the midground sand dunes, and then we have a beautiful landscape at the background in the horizon with the sun rising up. As you can see, the light falling onto my face, it is pretty golden and nice light for landscape photography. Now, let's see how the shot comes. So, I'll be shooting right now in manual mode, keeping my aperture close to f16, because I want to give sun that starburst kind of effect. And my shutter speed is close to 400. Remember one thing, when you're shooting sand dunes, the good time to shoot sand dunes is either early in the morning before the sun breaks, and late in the evening, because what happens is when you see the ripples on these dunes, they form beautiful shadows and patterns which looks beautiful in this kind of lighting condition. Afternoon, if you come here, the light will be pretty flat, there won't be much shadows and contrast on the dunes, so it won't add up to your landscape image. So let's take one shot as per rule of thirds, keeping sun in the left hand side of the corner, and take one shot. Let's see how it comes, and then we'll try and play around with certain more angles here, and if possible we'll try and accommodate a certain balancing element into it. So we actually got some pretty nice images here with the camel creating balancing element for us for the landscape image. And let's go back to the studio and review the images. So Naveen, here we are back to our studio.
Yeah.
So how was the shoot?
Abhishek, I have to say it was an amazing shoot. We had a wonderful time shooting, and like you already saw in the video, we had to tackle some dramatic climates because it kept changing all the time. So was the light, in fact.
Exactly.
It was magical, as well as sometime we had sort of dull light.
Though we were in certain location, we were into hills.
Right.
So, though we did our homework pretty well in terms of studying the weather, but a good landscape photographer should be always ready for bad weather as well. So Naveen, let's review the first image that we took in Kerala.
Let's do that. Yeah.
Here is the image. And what we did here is we actually implemented one of the rules of photography, which is called rule of thirds. So here you can see a tree in the right corner of the frame kept exactly on one of the intersection points as per the rule of third. And then we tried our best to accommodate three important elements of landscape photography, that is foreground, midground and background. When you talk about landscape photography, it's always about greater depth of field.
Absolutely.
And greater depth of field, one tip that I can give to all our viewers is keep your aperture above f8 to get good depth in your shot.
Yeah.
And try, if you're confused related to focusing, where to focus, focus on some interesting foreground element. Like in this case, tree is a very good foreground element.
Exactly.
So focus there, keeping your aperture like f8, f11 will give you greater depth of field and sharpness in your landscape image.
Absolutely.
If you see another image that we shot using a zoom lens, you can see a house in the corner of the frame, right corner of the frame, perfectly placed as per the rule of third on one of the intersection point. And then you get layers of mountain with background as dramatic sky.
And with the tele lens, as you can see, the layers have also got compressed.
So here we have used a zoom lens. And with the help of zoom lens, we are able to pull out another rule of landscape photography, which is called layers. So here we are showing layers in terms of one layer of mountain, second layer of mountain, and in the background we have dramatic sky. So Naveen, that was all about how you can implement rule of thirds and layers in your landscape photography. Let's review another image that we shot in one of the tea state in Kerala.
Yeah.
Keeping leading lines in mind. Now, leading lines is one of the rules of photography that adds depth to your image. Exactly. You shoot roads, paths, streets, railings, walls, and these kind of patterns in such a manner that either that leads you towards the subject or away from the subject. So the idea here is, since photography is a two-dimensional medium, as you can see this image, when a viewer watches this particular image, he will be moved into the image.
Absolutely, so that's what the line does in the image.
Exactly, it's kind of add depth to your image, and it is very important to find out these kind of patterns when you are exploring the landscape.
Also, anytime you find such leading lines, place them in your picture so that it travels from one corner into the other. Try not using them parallel, because again, your sense of depth is lost if it's just parallel lines.
Right.
So that makes it all the more effective.
Exactly. So this is one image. Now, this is a very ordinary looking landscape
image. There's still something missing in the image. Yeah. Don't you feel that?
Landscape image, Naveen, looks very beautiful if you add life to them. Let's review another image.
Yeah.
The same spot. And we have just added human element to it.
Right.
Now, adding human element adds much more life to your landscape shots. Now, see, the previous shot is looking quite flat. Yes, it has got depth in it, but adding human element adds much more drama
to
your image.
Yeah. And as life. You can already see in the image.
Exactly.
I know that you guys had been to Jaisalmer too, so I can't wait to see your picture there. Unfortunately, I missed it, but...
Yeah, that's a kind of perfect spot, I can say.
Yeah.
A good location for landscape photography with life.
How different was it? I mean, we are straight away heading from Kerala to sand dunes. I mean, green to brown. So, light conditions, anything that you can tell us about?
See, lighting condition is quite different from Kerala, because in Kerala we encountered a lot of
fog
and cloudy weather.
Correct.
But here, sky was pretty much clear, and early in the morning and late in the evening, we were getting good golden light. So, here is a shot you can see of just the landscape early in the morning at around 6:30, 7 o'clock in
the
morning.
Look at the light.
So, exactly. And what I have done here is, since there was nothing great in the foreground, so I have just kept the dunes, sand dunes in the foreground. And in the background, there is beautiful sunrise happening. And I have kept the sun as per the rule of thirds. But, you know, again, sticking to the basic elements of landscape photography, foreground, midground and background. Here you can see interesting foreground and interesting background, but there is nothing in the mid-ground.
Life again is again, also life. Missing.
So what I did, I waited there patiently, and after some time I see this.
Wow, okay.
So you can see some local element of that particular region adding life to my landscape shot.
We can't always afford to hire a model for landscape, can we?
So this is a good example of how you can actually include life in your landscape images. And keep in mind, as Naveen said, you cannot have models everywhere. So use your friends, family members, relatives. Don't ask them to pose, but to enjoy the scene. And that way you can actually pull out beautiful landscape image with life.
Yeah.
So here in Jaisalmer, I was pretty much fortunate to get this kind of element for my landscape photography.
Yeah.
And I think this has come out really well.
Absolutely, yes.
And shooting sand dunes is also one big challenge.
Okay.
You cannot shoot sand dunes in afternoon.
Right.
The best the light is early up. In the morning and late in the evening, wherein it forms beautiful shadows onto the patterns of the dunes.
Right, right.
So keep that in mind, that every region has its own essence that needs to be captured in a particular lighting condition only.
Like the tea estate had a sort of pattern. It was actually looking like a green carpet.
Exactly.
So I'm guessing same was the case in Jaisalmer with sand.
Exactly.
So let's leave you with some more pictures from this shoot. Till next time, we are your Nikon buddies, Abhishek and Naveen, signing off. Thank you.